Citylive, a platform to sharing your thoughts.
So good afternoon, guys. And this is an initiative by Federation of Rajasthan Event Managers. And we have two important people from different fields of industry. We have Atul with us. So Atul is a global management professional with over 25 years of experience and is the executive director for Delhi Central Region of BNI. He currently runs a firm, Deal Flow Ventures and Consultants, to help startups establishment. Hello, Atul. And we have Shweta Khurana. Shweta is an MPhil from English Literature and is the co-founder of Molimo Ice Creams and is by innovative by nature. And she currently heads the BNI Titans chapter in Jaipur. Hi, Shweta.
Hi.
So guys, we all know that these are tough times, but the smile on your faces shows that these tough times teaches us a lot of things and makes us positive. And once we are over this with this discussion, I think we'll be taking over a lot of positive points from your side, because the way you guys are actually executing and managing your regions and your professions, it gives us a very positive vibes. So quickly coming to Atul. So Atul, presently what I would like to understand from you is that how do you see the isolation period of COVID-19 beneficial in terms of your professional and personal development?
All right, so let's start with the COVID first. You know, these kind of situations or times, they come in industry on a very, very regular and in a cyclic manner. So if it was not COVID, something else was going to happen. In last 50 years, if we look back, there have been three economic slump. And the third one is happening right now. If it was not for COVID, it was going to happen anyway because of the world debt, which is actually almost three times the world GDP. So COVID is just one of the challenges in an entrepreneur's life. Entrepreneur's life is anyway full of challenges. This is just one of those things. So I actually look at this kind of situation as one of the challenges in a normal entrepreneur's life, nothing more than that. Secondly, during these kind of times, what big companies and successful companies do, I am trying to do the same thing. So when I talk about economic slump, because whether it's COVID or whether it's a debt problem, ultimately for an entrepreneur, it comes down to business loss, because that's what it translates into.
Right.
So when we know that there are no customers in the market, there are no customers because we are not able to go out and sell our products and services. So when that happens at larger scale around the world, what is it that big companies do? You know, big companies actually look inside and start developing something for future. They start working for future. That, you know, we have to accept the situation that there is a slowdown in business in the market. Even if you make a lot of effort, the result is not going to be proportional. So why don't we do something more valuable than that? So what is more valuable than that is planning for future. In this time, in any case, we can do only so much. It's very limited that we can do, but we can use this time very productively thinking about future. That how will I work, or how will my business be? How will it look after this whole situation is sorted? Because every big life-changing event like this one is, it is going to change the way we have lived our life till now. It is going to definitely change the way we have conducted our businesses now. So this is the best time to reinvent ourselves as entrepreneurs, to actually properly think about the future of our businesses and see exactly what will work in future in our field, and then start preparing for it. So that once the market becomes normal, then we will be the first one to launch new products or improve services with more commitment. And that's the only way we can survive and probably come out of the situation with flying colors. So these kind of times has to be used for reinventing ourselves and our businesses, which otherwise we will not do in day-to-day work. Once everything is normal, we are all busy in finding customers and servicing customers. We don't give enough time to think about the business which we are going to run for rest of our life. So the business that we are going to run for rest of our life, it deserves a few months of introspection. So probably this is a fantastic opportunity may be forced on us, but it still is a fantastic opportunity to think about our business, think about future of not just our business, of the way that we are going to live our lives going forward. And then how will we fit in into that picture? What will we have to do to our business and to ourselves to fit well in that situation or in that future picture? And just prepare for it. So this time has to be used for the reinvention of ourselves and our businesses and planning for future and ensuring that we'll fit in the future picture. So
great. So I bring something for your personal development as well, because business is definitely one of the major agendas of ours.
Yeah, when you talk about personal development, this whole introspection exercise is about reinventing all aspect of life, ourself also, because first thing first, you have to accept the situation, and accepting any kind of situation improves you as a human being. And then you start working towards future. Once you start spending a lot of time with yourself and start thinking about how will you plan, that improves you as a human being. So, and that is part of self-development. When you're planning your future venture, when you're planning to work on your business in future or making it fit for the future, you'll have to make a lot of changes in yourself. You'll have to acquire a lot of new skills also. You may have to work with other people and collaborate and find some synergies so that you can survive and come out of it, the situation with flying colors, with very, very minimum investment. So a lot of self-development will happen as part of the process anyway.
Thank you, Atul. So Shweta, coming back to you, how do you actually look at this perspective?
So very nicely, like Atul explained, we, I believe always there are two parts in your question, otherwise also in our lives also, if say there is a professional front and there's a personal front. Normally throughout our life, we always end up keeping, you know, professional part as upfront to our personal front. So now in this scenario, we have been forced upon to also look into our personal side. So where the learning is happening continuously, it is not just about the work, you know, every small thing that you are learning in your day-to-day routine, whether it is from your children or your husband and, you know, managing all things on your own, it is a different sort of learning. So I believe learning in any form is good. When it comes to professional side, things that we never thought of, as Atul said, you know, the big companies, the companies who are really progressive, things that we never thought that we'll ever, you know, get into these sort of collaborations. Now, collaboration is going to be a new word where everybody would want to collaborate and try new ideas and new thoughts where they can make things work. The most important, thing that will come out of this is there will be a lot of good, wonderful talent which is going to be available. And probably at a better price. So for my industry, probably, you know, in being in food line, I was looking for professionals who are in probably, you know, the salary range of couple of lakhs. So there is going to be a possibility that we will be able to afford them part-timely, partially with a, you know, affordable sort of income. So which is again a very good for any entrepreneur to grow. And also to think about ideas, like we never thought that our business can go online, you know. So now we are finding ways, we're trying to build new thing every day, scratching our mind and just taking out new innovative ideas. So right now we are cribbing about this time, but believe me, 21 days are gone, 19 days are ahead. And we are really going to remember this time. We have seen our parents talking that they haven't seen this sort of crisis in their lifetimes, which means for next couple of decades also, hopefully it is not going to come back. So we need to take this time as a blessing. The kind of time we have got, you know, to utilize, and the way nature has enforced upon us, it is actually a blessing in disguise. And when you see life, don't see it as a part, you know, a 6 months window or a 1 year window. It is a complete cycle. It is not just a matter of 6 months that the businesses are low or it is slow down. Just see it in a larger picture. Things are just going to emerge. It is just a matter of another 6 months or 1 year. We are going to grow far bigger, far smarter, far, you know, positive with a wonderful mindset. So I believe right now it is all about building positivity and working on the right things, which is very important.
Great. That was a good insight. Coming back to Atul, Atul, just want to understand, as we are talking on the positive approach and the coming times which are going to come, there's a very latest updates which are happening around in the country, that there are a lot of countries, as you are stating in, I mean, you're basically operating in the financial capital of India. So there are a lot of news which are coming that the companies, the corporates, many big business houses are actually migrating from China, and they're going probably right to the native place. Or otherwise, we are hearing a lot of things from the internal sources that a lot of business and a lot of new establishments are going to come down to India. So can you share your insight? I mean, what kind of information do you carry for this particular information, what we have as a normal, a general viewer?
Okay. I can give you my views about the overall situation. Whatever is happening in China, that may or may not have any positive impact on India. Because the ease of doing business in India is not there still, even after government has made a lot of effort. It's not very easy to operate in India on the business front. It's still very challenging. There are a lot of bureaucratic problems here. So this China problem started early 2019, US-China trade war. And then businesses started thinking about shifting out of China. COVID has only expedited the whole thing. But the whole thing started in 2009, and since then there is no company that has shifted from China to India. There is another aspect to it. When we talk about small to medium-sized business owners, we are an essential part of economy, but a very, very small part of this overall scheme of things. So even if 10 companies decide to shift from China to India, the impact on SME is going to be absolutely minimal. So we are not running our businesses thinking that some business will shift from China to India, then my business will prosper. India is too big for all kind of SMEs to prosper without any business shifting from China to India. It's a huge market. All the large size companies are coming to India. So I don't have to worry about what is happening in China. There is still a lot of market left for me to capture. I'm probably 0.0001% of the overall market cap in India. So I have a very, very long way before I start thinking if business shift from China to India, I will benefit. So that's how I see it. We still have a lot of ground. I personally believe that, because hamare yahan, when we talk about that part, hamare yahan consumer base bahut hi large hai. So we have all kind of consumers ready for all kind of services. When you talk about positivity, that Shweta spent a few minutes on, I personally believe is that that's the way of life. There's no other way. And for that positivity, I don't depend on, or my business growth, for my business growth, I don't depend on anything happening in China or in US. I did not start my business thinking that one day business will shift from China to India and my business will grow. I started it because I believe in it. And whatever happens in China, yes, we are going to grow because we have support of every Indian here. We are right. Going to support each other. We don't need any external support for anything.
No, definitely. So we are the most positive country in the world as of now, fighting with COVID, and we are the, and definitely we will be the winners out of it in a little span of time.
Absolutely.
So coming back to now core business, you head your central region in Delhi. Shweta heads basically a small version of BNI in Rajasthan, and probably I am fortunate that I launched this chapter with the team, and probably we are running it very successfully from last 11 months. Just wanted to understand from your perspective that how BNI has been a blessing in disguise in this particular lockdown period. Can you just help us understand how BNI has been a blessing in disguise?
You want me to take it or Shweta?
No, probably I want you to address and then I'll take it back to Shweta.
All right. So BNI has been a blessing, and no disguise needed, honestly, here. Because if you want to stay positive, you have to stay among people.
Right.
In the time like this, you cannot afford to isolate yourself. I see many businesses, many people going into isolation, just thinking, cutting off from world, that, you know, we are not doing well, we don't want to talk to people. This is not the time for that. This is the time to stay among positive people, so that you stay positive in life. you come out of it positively. And BNI plays such an important role in all of our lives that every day morning start with positivity of 50, 60 or 100 people. And once you are so energized during those 2 hours, rest of the day goes positive anyway. So BNI, I think BNI is fueling positivity in this environment. BNI is giving hope to everyone that not everything is lost. We are still doing business and we are all together still. We will support each other in good or bad times. So that I think BNI is doing what nobody can imagine right now. No government has been able to give that kind of confidence to their citizens. No institution is able to do it. It's BNI which is still giving so much confidence to all our members, and members are giving confidence to each other and to the organization that we are all together, we are one family, we'll take care of each other, good or bad times, and not everything is lost, we are still with each other. So I think BNI has been fantastic.
That's great. Shweta, would you like to share your insight?
Absolutely, sir. During this times, I have started one more term which I'm using very regularly in BNI, and it is called CNSD. Till now, we were just using SD, you know, social distancing. So I call it close networking via social distancing. So probably the amount of networking I'm doing now, I was not doing when we were socially networking. So the amount of people we are able to meet, you know, the amount of networking we are able to do now, it was never possible, you know, not more than one-to-one in a day. Nothing beyond that. That was also like, you know, somebody saying I've done 2-3 one-to-ones during this week. It was like, oh, wow. And now we are doing like 7-7 one-to-ones. And, you know, meeting people across region, across globe, which is like unbelievable. So BNI definitely has been, you know, a disguise. So today I shared a small story of a woodcutter in my chapter. So it's there are two woodcutters who are continuously cutting woods. So one is doing it continuously, the other is taking a break, and the person who's doing it continuously is able to cut far lesser wood than the guy who's taking a break. So because when we ask the guy that how come you are able to cut more, he says, because I'm giving rest to my axe, and that during that rest time, I'm sharpening my axes. So this is the time that we have got to sharpen our axes. The more we sharpen, the better, with lesser energy, we'll be able to cut. We'll be able to cut far more. So this is a blessed moments that we have to sharpen our axes, use our minds, so that we are actually able to perform better in coming times. So I think this is a beautiful BNI platform, which is adding to networking also, and also along with that, giving a lot of positivity also, which we all need right now. So all for BNI.
Great. So guys, thanks a lot for sharing your insights on all the concerned topics, and we really hope that things turn up more positive once we actually share this among our fraternities. And let's hope that we come up with flying colors, as Atul says, and we'll definitely come out of with flying colors after this lockdown goes over. So probably once again, I thank Atul and Shweta for being with us on this beautiful
Thank you very topic. Much.
And we'll soon get back to you with certain updates as well on this. Thank you, guys.
Sure. Thank you very much for hosting us. Have a good day.
Citylive, a platform to sharing your thoughts.